Hello, internet friends. My name is Valerie. Welcome to our first ever video in our new series where we go over 5 uncommon ways to roleplay each class. Today we'll be doing the cleric right now on Roll Initiative. Welcome back to Roll Initiative. On this channel, we like to talk about Dungeons and Dragons and give advice to DMs and players on how to roleplay different types of creatures and characters. If you're new here and that excites you, please subscribe. Before we get started, let's talk about a few cleric archetypes you're probably already familiar with. You've got your gleaming badass who's got a hammer and a holy symbol, and they're not afraid to dispense righteous justice in the name of their lord. Then on the other side, there's the gentle pacifist who ministers with kindness and hugs and compassion and kumbayas. On the other end of the alignment spectrum, there's your evil, eyeliner-wearing, mustache-twirling cultist who's sacrificing puppies in the name of the Raven Queen. What we're going to cover today is 5 unorthodox ways to approach this class. We're going to cover background features, domains, and interesting feats if those apply. First up, we've got the tribal shaman, who's going to be a more wild, barbarian style of cleric. They're going to take a more primal approach to religion and worship through sacrifice and ritual, even in the heat of battle. The aesthetic for this character is going to be a lot more primitive. They're going to have face paint and tribal tattoos, ritualistic scarification, wear leathers and furs and bones. They might have a shaved head with tattoos on it, or a mohawk, or dreadlocks, or piercings. For domain, you could go Tempest and be a conduit for the elemental spirits. You can harness thunder and lightning and roaring winds to aid your tribe in battle. Or you could go Grave Domain and be there to shepherd the spirits of your fallen comrades to the afterlife. For this character's background, we decided not to go with one of the pre-made backgrounds from the book. A lot of people don't know this, but there are rules in the player's handbook on page 125 on how to customize your own background. And that's what we've done here. We made the spiritual leader background. And for its skills, it's got survival to show its ability to navigate the wilderness, and insight because you think of a shaman as being able to read the true spirit of a man. For tools, we went with an herbalism kit so that your character can create antitoxins and potions of healing. And if you've gone with the Tempest variant, you can take one of the elemental languages. Otherwise, you can take another tool proficiency or language that best fits with your campaign. And for this character's background feature, we chose the Wanderer from the Outlander background. It represents your character's connection with their tribal lands. And finally, if you're using feats, we would recommend taking Elemental Adept if you're playing the Tempest variant so that you can be a Wild Thunder or Fire Shaman. Or you could take Ritual Caster that will allow you to find a familiar and let you see through the eyes of your spirit beast. Next up, we've got the Street Preacher, possibly homeless, a more urban style of cleric who lives amongst and ministers to the poorest of the poor. For domains, we went with the Solidarity domain to represent this character's unity with the little people, to be a protector of his flock. Or you could do the Light domain to be a beacon in the darkness for the downtrodden. Once again, we've decided to make our own background that we're calling Man of the People because this character spends his time amongst the masses, he's got his finger on the pulse of the city, and he hears and sees everything. For skills, we've gone with Investigation to show his awareness and ability to gather information from his flock, and Persuasion because what street preacher doesn't have a silver tongue? For tools, you can go with a gaming set and a language, or 2 bonus languages that he's picked up from the people of the slums that he frequents. For background feature, you can either go with Rustic Hospitality from the Folk Hero background to show the goodwill that your character has earned from his flock, or City Secrets from the Urchin background that will demonstrate his knowledge from living on the streets. And finally, for feats, you can take Observant, which will demonstrate that he is the eyes and ears of the city, or Keen Mind, which will allow him to recall anything he's seen or heard on the streets. Next up, we've got the Divine Huntress. She's the follower of a nature god and worships through ritualistic hunting. Her domain's gonna be pretty straightforward. We went with nature, and that's gonna give her the ability to be in tune with the animals and plants in her environment. Like the other two, we've come up with our own background that we're calling Priestess of the Hunt. Her skills are going to be survival that will allow her to track her prey, and stealth that will allow her to sneak up and get a clean kill. For tools, we have given her proficiency in an herbalism kit and tinker's tools that will allow her to make traps. For the background feature, we went with At Home in the Wild from the Tickle Belly Nomad that will allow her to find places to hide, rest, and recuperate while out in the wild. And for feats, we've got Sharpshooter for the Skilled Bow Hunter or Polar Master for the Spear-Wielding variant. For this next cleric, darkness isn't just for the warlock. We call it the God's Blade, a cultist-like killer who worships death through assassination. Pretty straightforward, this one is Death Domain. They weave divine magic with necromancy. Once again, we've made our own background. This one is called Death's Disciple. This character is going to be proficient in stealth and deception. For tools, we've gone with a proficiency in a poisoner's kit and a disguise kit. For our background feature, we're either going to take the charlatan's false identity or safe haven from faction agent that will allow our character to take refuge with fellow cultists. Lastly, for feats, skulker for skulking.
Grab your hat and your whip for this last cleric because we call it the Relic Hunter. It's going to be an adventurous cleric that searches through ancient ruins for lost relics of its faith.
For this character, we have gone with the knowledge domain for three reasons. The first of which is that it will give you additional skills. We have chosen investigation and athletics, and the additional languages that will help you in your search for ancient artifacts. Second, you can use your channel divinity to become proficient with any tool you might need on your hunt. And third, you can use the Visions of the Past ability to gain additional information about objects or your surroundings. For our background, we kept it simple. Take Archaeologist. It will give you maps of dungeons. The historical knowledge feature will allow you additional information about dungeons and ruins, and you can even appraise ancient artifacts. For your feats, take Dungeon Delver or Lucky. That will allow you to live out your Indiana Jones fantasy. And that is it. If you've got something to say, please drop a comment below. If you liked this video, please hit like. If you want to see more videos like this, hit subscribe. And if you want to be notified when we have new content, click the bell. So now you know you can make a character that is interesting without being weird for the sake of weird. Like a tiefling made of cotton candy that rides a unicorn. So until next time, may my God have mercy on your soul. We'll be right back.